Yo, what's going on YouTube? Nasif here from Click, and today I'll be doing a little bit of a different video here. So I got the Galaxy S6 quite a while ago. I know it's an older device, but I figured what the hell, why not record? I also got a different setup here. So I got two tripods. Shout out to my grandpa, hooked me up with a second tripod out of nowhere. So I got one hooked up here with one of the phones. I got one up here, if you guys can see. So I'm gonna try and play around with it a little bit. We'll see how the video turns out. I mean, I know this tripod is a little bit in my face to get a message on my Apple Watch. It is what it is. I know the tripod's a little bit in the face, but I figured it'd be a little bit cooler just rather than looking at hands moving around, playing around with the phone to show you guys my face while I'm talking to you. So it is what it is. Anyways, guys, so I'll show you guys the S6. So now I got this on eBay. We got, what was it, 32 gig Sprint variant, I believe. So this costs 300 in total. So I got a little bit of a hookup with the eBay seller. I don't think he'll do it for everyone. I am a frequent buyer of this seller, wireless.canada. So I bought the lower condition S6. He ended up sending me the 10 out of 10 condition. And guys, honestly, if you guys can see here, this is definitely 10 out of 10. Others, you know, mind the fingerprints. There's no way around them with the S6. But like the bezel is perfect condition. Everything is mint. Like I know I said the same thing about the, I got a little bit of dirt here. That's nice. I know I said the same thing about the LG V10, and look where that ended up, but it is what it is. But yeah, guys, I just wanted to do a little bit of a review. So I know people like me, they don't want to spend hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of dollars on phones. They'd rather spend a couple hundred dollars, get a nice, decent device. So I know the Galaxy S6 is a wicked flagship phone to have. And I'm just going to be doing the usual review stuff. So I've been using the phone now for probably, I'd say, I don't know, a couple days at least. No, not a couple days, like almost a week of it being my daily driver phone. And guys, it has been awesome. So I'll talk a little bit about the, I got to bump the brightness here for you guys. So let's see here. So we have the Galaxy S6, guys, and obviously it's a 5.1 or 5.2 inch display. Honestly, guys, this display is wicked. The screen is amazing. I have no problems with it. Like, I think it's a 2K AMOLED display. I don't know the resolution on top of my head. PPI is like 500 plus. It's nuts. The pictures look amazingly sharp. The videos look awesome. And it's just awesome. The size is perfect. Like, I can navigate the whole phone basically with one finger, or sorry, one thumb, one hand, and it's just wicked. Like, there's no delay anywhere. And I'll get into the whole software thing. Yeah, you guys saw my fake GPS go, man. I'm not trying to play Pokemon Go legit. But yeah, guys, so the display is, honestly, it's wicked. That's just by far, if you're looking to buy the Galaxy S6 just for the display, do it. In terms of software performance, you guys can see here, it's just like there's no delay in anything. Stuff loads up right away, and it's just there's no delay whatsoever loading anything up. If I open up the gear manager here, that's nice and quick. Settings app, we had it open earlier. Just everything's nice and fluid. I know it's not a Verizon variant, sorry, it's a Sprint variant, I believe. But just in general, things just open, it's nice and snappy, and considering it's a two-year-old phone, I mean, you can't go wrong. You really can't go wrong with a device like this. In terms of the camera, I'll take a quick picture here for you guys. So we'll take a picture of the camera there. So I don't know if you guys can see. We're gonna load that up there. It's pretty, pretty solid. I mean, the lighting in here is kind of whack, but I mean, you got that slick Made in Japan logo, it's nice and clear. The photo quality is amazing. I'll take another picture of just the mess that's over here on the desk. You guys can see, just even in poor quality lighting, it's just amazing. The quality of the photos that come out of this phone, considering it's 2 years old, honestly compares to flagships that are out right now. The Galaxy S7, the Note 7 when it was still around, you know, rest in peace. But it honestly is on par with my Note 5, which I'm recording with up here. Is on par with it, hands down. Differences between them, not really much. So if you're looking, you know, do I go Note 5 and S6 for the camera? Honestly, the S6 is a little bit cheaper. Just get the S6. It's honestly the same camera. You're not going to notice any difference at all. In terms of the, what else am I going to talk about? The battery. I mean, it's average. The battery life is not the best in the world. I'll take a look and see some of the stats here. So we'll get the screen on time. So we got three and a half hours of screen on time. I've got 14% left on the battery. So I mean, it's average screen on time, not the best in the world. I have the Pure XR that I'm recording with over here. That gives me about 4 hours. You know, it's a little bit less than average because phones nowadays are getting about four and a half hours screen on time. So it is what it is. Not a huge deal, not a deal breaker. It'll definitely get you from, you know, a 9 to 5 day. And the thing is, it has quick charge, so the charging times are nuts. It's like you just plug it in and you're up to date. You know, your charge is up to 100% before you know it. So awesome on that end. We were talking about the hardware. I mean, obviously it's a Samsung device, guys. Check it out. Like the glass, the metal, the glass. I mean, as slippery as it is and as bad as it is to handle in the hand, it's an amazing device. Now, I do have the Rhino Shield case, which is the only case I'm probably going to buy for this just because I love the way this S6 feels in the hand. And with this bumper, guys, it gives you that protection. Apparently, it's rated for, it's supposed to be rated for 11 foot or 11 feet and higher drops. So, I mean, if I drop the phone, it's going to be protected. No problem. But yeah, guys, I mean, other than that, I generally rock the phone naked at home. If I go out, I'll put the Rhino Shield on. I'm not going to turn it into a case review, but it is what it is. So that's pretty much it for that in terms of build. Now, the buttons and stuff are nice and clicky as usual with Samsung devices. The speaker is something a little bit lacking. I mean, it's not the best in the world, but it is what it is. Let's load up some NCS here. Non-copyright. Come on. Where you at? Where you at? Here we go. We'll just go non-copyright music and we'll just shuffle it. I mean, the speaker, it's loud. Don't get me wrong. The speaker is definitely loud, but compared to the iPhone, it has my 6 Plus anyway, it has a little bit more bass. But this one is very loud. Like, don't get me wrong, it's a very loud speaker. It's just lacking, not lacking. I mean, it doesn't have as much bass as the iPhone. Still sounds good, but you know, I've had the iPhone, I've had dual front-facing speaker phones. It's hard to compare between the two, so it is what it is. And what else did I want to talk about? So I talked about the cameras, the software, the hardware, battery life. The problem I also, I just wanted to mention one thing that I've had a problem with this phone. So it is a Sprint variant, I believe. So I'm not getting LTE out here in Canada. If you guys know any way to get LTE on a Sprint variant phone with Rogers, drop a comment down below and let me know as I get another message there. But yeah, just let me know in the comments down below because it's not a huge deal. I still get my 3G connection. I just don't get LTE, but it would be nice. I did spend $300 on it. Would be nice to have LTE connection out here in Canada. But again, this is what it is. I don't really use my data much. I've got WhatsApp, and that's pretty much it. It's the only thing I use my data for. But it is what it is. Would be nice to have LTE. Other things I don't like about the phone, as slippery, you know, it's slippery. It's something I can live with. I've got the Rhino Shield, which actually adds a lot of grip. Anything else that I don't really like about the phone? The home button. I mean, the home button's okay. The fingerprint scanner is not as accurate as an iPhone. So I find myself sometimes having to rescan a couple times, but I'm not going to try and replicate it here. Happens once in a blue moon where the fingerprint scanner doesn't work and you just gotta put your password in. I think I covered everything I wanted to talk about. I got the screen, the speakers, the camera. I covered build, the software. Is there anything else that I'm missing here? Headphone jack? I mean, I haven't really used it to be honest, so I would really wouldn't be able to tell you. But I think I covered everything. And I mean, guys, we'll go to the end of the video now. It's been 8 minutes, Jesus Christ. Do I recommend this device? Yeah, if you're in the market for a Galaxy S6 and you need, or any, you know, if you're just in the market for a phone and your budget's 300, anywhere between $200 and $300. I'd say just spend that little bit more, that 300, get a mint Galaxy S6, guys. It's an amazing phone. There's no reason why you should get a blue phone over this because blue phones suck. There's no reason why you should get like a BlackBerry or, you know, a Huawei phone. Just get the Samsung. Trust me, it is top of the line, especially considering it's 2 years old, guys. Keep in mind, I mean, the S8's not out officially, but this is a 2-year-old phone and it's still competing with the best of them. So that's all I can say about that, guys. It's just an awesome phone. Yeah, obviously you don't get, you know, the buttery smooth edges like the Galaxy S7, but I mean, small things like that, really, is it worth that extra $500 you need to pay? I don't think so. So it is what it is, guys. Anyways, guys, that's pretty much it. This review is more for the people like me who are looking to buy a phone and they don't want to spend tons of money on it. You still pick up a nice flagship device. Anyways, guys, thanks so much for watching. Let me know what you guys think about this kind of camera view and the switching around and whatever. Let me know what you guys think. If this tripod is in the way too much, I'll try and figure something else out. But as of right now, I think this is the way it's gonna be until I can mount a camera up there either in the ceiling or something, but that's for later on because I'm thinking of moving my office down to the basement, get a little bit better lighting. But it is what it is. That's something we'll look at in the future. Anyways, guys, thanks so much for watching. If you like this video, feel free to drop a like on the video, as always. And if you guys like the content on the channel, feel free to subscribe to us. If you have any questions, comments, concerns about the phone or anything else on the channel, drop a comment down below, and we'll get back to you as soon as we can. Anyways, guys, this has been Nasif from Click, and I'm out. Peace.